Land of food and water.
Yeah.
Give it to me three times, yeah. Give it to me four times.
We live music, wake up, go to bed music. Think of a small island with like about 300 and odd studios.
A lot of people's reading and writing ability is very limited. So our ability to talk and communicate has been a lot through music, and we're a very rhythmic country.
Jamaican thing, that man. It's a Jamaican thing.
I would say Minto came from many other different kind of music, like the Pocomania, and you know, other music like that.
What is the Pocomania?
What is the Pocomania?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I think it's a traditional dance, you know, from Africa.
Kumina, Pocomania are rooted in African tradition, and they have helped to identify the Jamaican sound.
Kumina is a dance of giving praise to the invisible, yet visible.
Kumina is totally Congolese. It comes straight from Africa.
Matilda, Matilda, she take the money and run Venezuela. Sing a little louder, Matilda. Sing out the chorus, you know, how that sound. It's the same kind of mood, you know. Mental mood, like, you know.
So mental is the music that makes the people happy. And from mental comes out all different kind of music.
Sit down. I don't know what to say, the monkey won't do.
From an old mentor, no, in scare.
This kind of music, you see, is the first kind of music in Jamaica. And the first kind of dance.
Come on, darling. Let me show you. Okay. Ska, ska, ska. This way. Spin, baby. Spin. Okay.
The music in America changed, and it went to rock and roll. Rock and roll wasn't popular here. It wasn't it. You understand? It didn't have that drive that we were looking for.
Part of the whole world movement, where the beats were getting faster and so on, Jamaican beats got faster. So that helped to identify and shape ska. But the Kumina influences and Pocomino influences were still there. It's still there in the background. You can hear it in some of the beats.
Carolina, my darling, you know I love is for you. Carolina, my darling, you know I love is for you. Oh, Carolina.
Ska was influenced by Mento and American music.
Well, Mento is just Mento, man. Ska is ska. It's progressive. And is more inclined to jazz music, mm-hmm. You know?
Horns
and nice soloing and stuff like that.
After that fast movement of the ska, you know? And the different. Maybe the people just wanted to relax now. Mm-hmm. So then came the rock steady. Easier music, you know? That's the sway.
One, two, three, I gotta make. Four, five, six, I gotta make. Seven, eight, nine, I gotta make. Ten, baby, going back to school again. A, B, B, C, we go to D. E, F, G, H, I, J, K.
Rocksteady came with a melodious rhythm section. You could always what the bass line is saying or the rhythm section is saying.
Mm-hmm. They say, how you ready? Come do rocksteady, yeah. You gotta do it just like Uncle Freddy. If you don't know, shake your feet, rock your body line. You know, that's rocksteady, more colorful melody. You understand me? Different from the ska, 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 pa, 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 Jamaican ska.
You move from ska and this is rocksteady. You want it to go somewhere else. So, before giving rocksteady a proper time, then you come in with the reggae.
You should never, never give up. You should never give up. Never give up the struggle. Oh no, never give up the struggle. I said, never give up. No way. We never, never give up.
Because there is a beat that play in reggae that nobody plays. Can only be heard by inspired musicians.
What is it?
Can't tell you. You'll have to hear it for yourself.
Okay.
Reggae just come with that, keeping that bass line, but you have that inside movement, that shuffle, with the organ in the middle, and that's reggae.
We
like to put a positive energy out there, which is roots rock reggae. Reggae with feeling, reggae with meaning. You know, something that can uplift you.
Just like a Zumbo, I'm a every day we come for chant. Highly King Selassie, I embrace. And I'm gonna collect so much in you to this. How you know we come for stop the billion? Nobody rise, I don't know, kill the prophet. Why not? No, no, kill those standing at your pulpit. Well, you use them to stray the minds of the youth as they grow. The youth sees from the window to this. This is the truth about my circumstances.
If you don't have the drum and bass from Jamaica, you'll play some real fast reggae that have no good feeling, you know, just fast. But once it's from Jamaica, once the drum and the bass originally from Jamaica, it's that roots in you that doesn't leave you. Anywhere you are, it's there.
Rhythm is one. The rhythm is what is there. You know, it's really that heavy bass that speaks to the art. You know, it like boom, boom. You know, it speaks to the art. And then now with that heavy bass and that message with it, that is what is holding the music. You know, people is listening and saying, "Wow, this guy is." You know, he's saying what I feel. He's saying what my situation. He's feeling what I am feeling.
Reggae music is like poor people music. And it's roots music. It's sufferation music. To be a good singer and a good musician, you have to be, with reggae music, you have to suffer a lot. Put it that way. You have to go through a bit of hardship.
If you can't stop that, stand up, face the facts. What is to come, no one can stop that. Ain't no stopping me, no, instead.
Okay.
What's up, man?
Yeah, we just got the pineapple here, we got the sugar cane, we got the little banana. This is the last that leave now, so we just want to sail it out and go, you know? Yeah. My respect.
From a long time, people didn't know what Rasta was. But as the time go by, people start to understand it. That's why you've got the roots music with saying Rasta, Bob Marley, love, love. And in those days, like, people never understand what Rasta is. So they used to sing my boy Lollipop or my darling go away or come back darling or whatever.
It is Rastafari that keep the power in the reggae. Every artist that is known to the world today in reggae that has helped to shape and keep music going is Rasta.
Queen Eliza Margaret, oh,
Rastafari was the name of Haile Selassie before he was crowned. The idea of Rastafarians come out of the man Rastafari, and he was Rastafari before he was Haile Selassie.
All right, some people say Jesus Christ, some people say Allah. Some people call him in different names, okay? Well, I call him Haile Selassie.
This is Haile Selassie, the Almighty. This is Haile Selassie, the Almighty. Salute to the king, you know.
He is the ruler of all things, yeah? He's the one, he's the king of kings, Lord of Lords, conquering land, tribe of Judah.
Babylon, the great stone, God's to move.
Naya Bingi is the vibes of the people, heartbeat of the people. Yeah? Jumps, everything come it started from the jumps.
Some reggae, which is pure Naya Bingi style, which is like even the Rastaman chant that Bob Marley did, that song was a. No one hear the words of the Rastaman say. With that drum thing, that's Naya Bingi.
Make we lick it in a dancehall style. All kind of people come and dance. All kind of people come and dance. All kind of people come and dance.
From reggae, which was largely late 1960s, 1970s. That's where was a heyday of reggae, as we tend to look on it. Was largely influenced by people like Jimmy Cliff, Bob Marley, Peter Tosh, Ken Booth, Ernie Smith. There are so many luminaries in the music who influenced this. But it was also part of a general movement of musicians trying to create that sound.
What make you draw back yard? You know fit draw back yard. Propaganda spreading over my name. Say you wanna bring another life to shame. Oh man, you're just a playing a game. What make you draw back yard?
But Bob really has something about him, even his delivery. And you know that way about Bob. I think that's what made him. And he was very creative. And I saw it that you'd be a big artist. Never dreamt that you'd be that large.
What make you draw that yard? What make you draw that yard? I want to disturb my neighbor, cause I'm feeling so right. I want to turn up my disco, show them the full watch tonight.
There are two schools of thought. One that reggae died with Bob Marley. Whereas I tend to think that reggae martyred reggae music. Bob's death made him a martyr and a champion of reggae.
You would have much more singers than DJ if Bob was around, because he will show them and they will copy his footsteps. But nobody is there to show anybody anything, so everybody just DJ.
The dance and music comes with a certain quickness. You see, the reggae music was laid back. The dance and music is more quick, so you don't have no time to hear. It is more reflecting to your body rather than to your mind. You know? The dance and music is more of a body thing, you know. When there was ganja, there was like a ganja thing, now there's cocaine. You know, yeah. When there was red, gold and green, now there's gold chain. You know, when there was lax, now it's just shine head, you know, ball head, you know. So it's like a total reversal of the culture, you know.
As I said before, when dancehall started, it was a sound system with a selector who, in between turning over the record to play the B-side, has to say something to keep the crowd active.
Well, I would describe a sound system now as a sound system is they got up equipment like amplifier, boxes, okay? That means that you can go anywhere and play. The sound system, I think, is a power, you know? Start of the music thing, you know? Where certain music usually play in the dance hall, but doesn't play on the radio.
Sound system was the main thing that exposed the music to the people, because in the early the radio station refused to play our music, snub it, figure it wasn't getting anywhere.
So he's out of playing at the dance hall, rapping with the people, that the music gets so popular.
They became the poor man radio station. They became the outlet for the ears of the hungry public who did not want this diet of foreign music. They wanted our own music. And the sound systems provided that outlet. Dub was also a major influence on dancehall, because dub is more rhythmic than melodic, and it created this platform again on which our dancehall artists could create the kind of lyrical form they have.
When the DJ and the sound had just a dub, then they would create their own thing to the dub. It's like another song being created.
The dancehall music to me is the more authentic of the Jamaican rhythms, because it don't draw from outside forces. It is more raw Jamaican. You know, the dancehall is really returning to a kind of African mind, body move. You know, it relates to the body.
Yes, my ladies, love her to this.
And the closer you stay to the culture, the African culture, is more you will see the movement structure becoming more African in its the way it moved.
A beat and you're like over here and a dancehall tune is playing over there and you just hear the beat, you will think you're listening to Kumina until you get near. You say, oh, it's a dancehall song, because them have the same kind of inside of it.
Jamaica music will always stay put and it will always be there. No matter what happens, everything will be like this, around and around, come back around.
I said, yeah, I said, yeah, what they say. Myself, so I was innocent. What they done to me, they was wrong.